who, being in very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be used to be his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing, by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man. He humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name. Philippians 2, verse 6 to 9. Today's text contains a massive paradigm shift for us as believers. Jesus came and made himself nothing. The God of everything, the God who is everything, became nothing, emptying himself not of his divinity, but setting aside his divine privileges by taking on his humanity. In this way, his emptying is not a subtraction of his divinity, but an addition of his humanity. The result? Humility and obedience. Humility and obedience are two sides of the same coin. Humility is required for obedience, and obedience is the result of humility. Well, it's one thing to die, it's another thing to suffer and die. That's the obedience that Jesus is showing us, death on a cross. This is also the act of ultimate obedience, because Jesus shows the ultimate humility. This is because Jesus is the ultimate servant. It's ironic that we are not saved through God's, you know, majestic, glorious thing, but through his humility. It is also ironic that God's love is shown mostly not in his glory, but in his humility. Or I can even say in his humiliation. Isaac Watts wrote in his beautiful hymn, "When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, my richest gain I count but loss, and pour contempt on all my pride. Were the whole realm of nature mine, that were a present far too small, love so amazing, so divine, demands my soul, my life, my all." This is our reflection for today. Let us survey the wondrous cross.